me say?
What made you say that?
Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes?
What made you say that?
Have you been listening to your heart? It's too late now. You don't want to take it back. 'Cause I know love's what made you say that. What took you so long? That's what I've been waiting on. I thought you'd take forever and a day.
What made you say that?
Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes?
What made you say that?
Have you been listening to your heart? It's too late now. I won't let you take it back. 'Cause I know love's what made you say that. Was it the starlight in your eyes?
What made you say that?
Have you been listening to your heart? It's too late now. You don't wanna take it back. 'Cause I know love's what made you say that.
What made you say that?
Oh, what made you say that? What made you say that?
Don't stop there. Roll the rest of it. Can we watch the rest of it? No. We want to say thanks to Diane Davis, who is doing some backup vocals along with Eric Silver, mm-hmm. and our buddy Jack Daniels, formerly mm-hmm. with Highway 101, yeah. who's backing up Shania Twain over there. Shania, mm-hmm. welcome to the show. You look terrific on camera. You really do.
Well, thank you.
Well, the first thing we have to ask you is, I'm sure you saw Robert Orman's commentary on sex in music videos.
Yeah.
And of course, he used you as an example of being a very sexy lady in video. Is this something that you are conscious of? That you look really terrific in these
Well,
videos.
You know, I think that all women, I mean, men too, but I mean, I think women in general really like to look their best,
mm-hmm.
and
sure.
That's all I'm out to do, just look my best, and I like to be proud of the way I look, and I think all women do.
Well, you should be, because, you know, I think one of the important aspects of the business these days is presentation, you know,
yes.
and looks play an important role in that, and you definitely have the looks to back up what I think is a wonderful song. Is that true what you told me? This is the last one you recorded for the album?
No, I lied.
Oh, you lied?
No, this is true.
Women always want to look their best and lie. No.
Oh, we're
really
good at lying.
No, that's what you did, right?
I'm just teasing you. I'm in a teasing mood right now. No, this is true. I kind of snuck this song in at the last minute. We had, I'm just guessing, we had around 45 minutes left to our session. It was the last session. We had already chosen the songs we really wanted to keep.
Yeah.
And I said, you know, can we kind of squeeze this one in here? And we did, and I'm glad that we did.
That's good. So,
well, now, being a new,
the first one up.
Being
yeah.
a new artist in country music, the fans and our viewers always want to know, like, you know, where did she come from and what she'd been doing with the other part of her life. Do you remember the first time you sang in front of people where you realized that performing was really wonderful, that you were actually getting attention from people?
Oh, well, I mean, my first stage was when I was 3 years old, and my mother would put me up on restaurant countertops to sing along with the jukebox. So I've been performing so long and singing so long that I can't really, you know, remember the turning point, you know, when it really became, when I considered it performance. I think it's just always been such a natural thing. But I remember for a long time, up until I was, I would say even 20, mm-hmm. I was very nervous. I experienced a lot of stage fright. Especially as a child, I was terrified.
Really?
I wanted to do it, but I was just so terrified.
So how'd you get over it?
Just doing it.
Just by doing it, yeah.
Doing it a lot. You know what, it's like you don't run away from your fears. I'm glad that I didn't. Or probably would be in the studio singing and mm-hmm. that's it. You know.
Well, there's another aspect of your career, too, that we want to bring up, and that is that you see all this glamour, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm trying to imagine, because they tell us that you worked in a reforestation project, which means you work way back up in
oh, yeah.
the forest.
Yeah.
In some pretty rough conditions.
No hairspray and lipstick out there, I can tell you that. No, it
well, was... she wouldn't survive, I know that, but I mean...
We all would.
You don't know what I could do, Charlie Chase.
You never know what's behind us. I mean, mm-hmm. I'm serious.
Well, what kind of job did you have? It was back up, way back up in the
forest area. Canada, in the northern woods, way back in the, Great White North kind of place, actually Timmins area mm-hmm. in Ontario. My parents had a reforestation company,
right.
and I was a crew boss, and I had 13 men on my crew, and we planted trees, millions of trees, put them back into the earth, and a lot of hard work, lots of black flies. And there's no shelter. You work with no shelter. You're outside all day, 12, 15 hours a day, and you live in a tent, and you eat beans and sausages
and
for 6 months. And moose. We did a lot of hunting on the planting mm-hmm. sites, and we ate a mm-hmm. lot off the land, things like that.
So you did that 6 months out of the year, and then you would go work the nightclubs, I guess,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'd go back to the city, which was Toronto, and I would get back into a sequin gown or whatever it was at the time, and I would, get on stage and perform.
That's amazing.
And pursue my musical career.
What a transition, huh?
Do you know what, though? This sounds like my dream job. You got to boss 13 men all day long?
Yeah!
Oh. What a lovely thing.
Oh, the only way to succeed, though, is to be one of the guys. You know, that's the only way.
Was that an easy thing to do, to be the boss of these other guys?
Well, I would go through a two-week adjustment period every time I would come from the city,
mm-hmm.
and we would all adjust to each other. And, I guess you have to have some kind of leadership qualities to begin with, but... we're just all people, and we would enjoy ourselves. And you're out with nature. I think you have a completely different point of view mm-hmm. on life when you really get down to the basics. Your values change completely.
Oh,
and
yeah.
it's a wonderful thing. It's very luxurious to not have to worry about what you're going to wear to work. And so you're not judged that way by the guys.
Sure.
So you really do become one of the guys.
That's interesting.
Well, you've got a lot of guys under your control now for the video on the first single here. I guess a lot of people came to know you through the Triple Play promotion, which was you and two other artists, right?
John Brannon and Toby Keith. They're both doing very well. And it was a brilliant marketing idea by the label.
Mm-hmm.
I was really excited to be a part of that because we got so much exposure that we would never have gotten this early in the game. I mean, this is my first single, my first album ever, my first recording contract.
Right.
So for all this to be happening at this stage of the game is, exciting, and Triple Play is very much responsible for all of that.
That's great.
So.
It was a big promotion, Lynn. You met a lot of people. You performed a lot of concerts.
Yes.
On that,
I mean, we played Billy Bob's and all kinds of places.
That's
like
great.
That. And it's just like, wow, I thought only people with hit records and did this. And this is before my single even came out.
Oh.
So this was so exciting.
Well, my sense is, I've just met you, but my sense is you have a lot on the ball, and I think this would have happened anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But it's nice it's happening sooner than later, I guess.
Yeah, sooner than later,
absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, well, she's going to be busy. Let's show you mm-hmm. where you can see Shania Twain in concert in Birmingham, Alabama, Atlanta, Georgia, then on to Charlotte, North Carolina, and you can write to her. My letter is going to 42 Music Square West. Suite 132, Nashville 37203.
And this is the album called Shania Twain.
Mm-hmm.
That's easy to remember because it's so unusual, and there's a pretty picture
name.
On the cover. Much luck to you.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me. I'm so glad to finally be here. Last year I was sitting in the audience with
You're
my sister.
You're kidding.
I wasn't, and I met you. You came and talked to me, but you didn't know who I was really at the time.
No kidding. Were we nice to you?
You were wonderful.
Good.
You said, can't wait to have you on the show. Here
I
am.
Here you are.
Did I say something stupid?
No. You were funny as usual. We had a good time.
In other words, she's saying that you were stupid as usual.
Yeah, maybe so. She's a lovely lady. Great song.
A lot of fun. Thanks, Shania.
We'll be back in a minute.